Hey everyone, it's Sahand from DetailsPro. In this video, I'm going to show you how to design with Command K. What does Command K mean? That is the keyboard shortcut that the new DetailsPro update is all about. So I've got my iPad here, I've got my Magic Keyboard, and I'm going to show you how to make designs like this one and any design that you'd normally make, but do it all from your keyboard. So you can do it really fast, you can do it with really efficient shortcuts, and you can do it all without touching the screen. So let's get into this and start. So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna delete this whole thing. And how am I gonna do that? I'm actually gonna do it from the keyboard with the new shortcut. So I'm gonna hold down the Command key. And if I use the arrows up and down, you'll see I can toggle up and down between all the elements in my design. So first things first, I'm just gonna go up and I'm gonna hit Command K. That opens up the new keyboard shortcut menu. The command menu, the command K menu, a lot of different names. But what you'll see in here is you'll see a list of actions that you can arrow through, and you'll see that there's a kind of a search bar at the top where you can filter those actions and do things. So I'm just gonna go ahead with the, you'll notice I had that top level element selected. So command, you know, I went all the way up to the top, command K, and I'm gonna start typing in delete, don't even need to type in the whole thing. And I'm just gonna go ahead and hit enter. Okay, so that is the basics of how you use Command K. You've already seen it. You just hit Command K, this thing pops up, and you can search, or you can use your arrows. You can hit enter and, you know, look at all the different actions. And you hit Command K, it goes away. You can also, if you need to, you can tap outside of it to get rid of it. So let's go ahead and start that design. So that was a design for sort of a news recipe cookbook style app where we're showing off maybe like a little item about a recipe. So let's start with the most basic thing. Let's add in some text. So I'm gonna hit Command K. And what I would do is I would just start typing in text, and you'll see, there we go, add element text. So enter or return. And I'm gonna type in blackberry apple pie, return. And there you go. So just like that, we've got an element. We picked something. We even preloaded the text that we want into the element. That's one of my favorite things. You'll see a lot of these keyboard shortcuts let you pick something and customize it in one action. And I think that was really important. I tested this a lot to make it feel really natural. So I hope that you enjoy that part. So, okay, we got the text. Let's go ahead and put the basic structure together, and then we'll add the fonts and we'll make it look nice. So we want a vertical stack for what we're doing. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit Command K again. And since I have the text element selected, which you can see by it being blue and you can see by the actions being about text, I can just go ahead and go down and go to new stack with item, return, and I can do vertical stack. So in place, that replaces any of your elements with a stack containing what you had. I could also do that by just typing in vstack, and you'll see there was that action, or vertical, you know, or even just stack. So a lot of quick ways to do things here. So there's that. Next thing we want to do is we want to add in the image. So I'm going to go over here to Command K again, and you'll see there's add element after. There's also add element before. We want the image to be above this text, so add element before is the one we want. So add element before. I'll start typing in image, and you'll see not only can you pick image, you can also just select actual images from your media library. So any pictures you've used in your designs, they're going to be sorted here from most recent to least recent. And I just think this is really great because I think as designers, we reuse pictures all the time because we basically just work on one or two different, you know, domains at a time. So why would you have to keep re-importing images? So let's go ahead and add in that picture of the pie. That's right here at the top. Okay, so it's pretty big because we don't have any frame on anything. So but I mean, it does look right. So I'm gonna go ahead and go up to the V stack, and I'm gonna do Command K. Now let's add our first modifier. So we haven't done that yet. You can either go to add modifier, and you've got all the modifiers that you've learned how to use, or you can just start typing in a modifier, so frame. Or you can even start typing in the something about what you're trying to do. So for example, my concern here is width. I just want this to have a set width. I'm not really concerned with the height. So if I just start typing in width, you'll see that I can add a frame with a set and with an action of setting the width. So I'm gonna go ahead and return, and I can just type in like 350. So in one step, we added a frame with a width of 350. Super cool. While we're on this V stack, let's do leading alignment. So I could, you know, Command K, I could go into change, or I could just start typing in leading way faster. Amazing. And I think that's actually it for customizing the V stack. So let's go ahead and step down to the image. I'm going to do a corner radius. I tapped the trackpad there, sorry. So corner radius, you'll see some actions, you know, you could type in, for example, you know, 25 or 24, and you can type whatever you want, or 24 happens to be a preset. So if that's something that you're going to use, you can just arrow down and return on 24. So I added those in there to make it really fast, because as designers, I feel like we use, you know, 4, 8, 10, 20. We use these values a lot. So might as well save time typing them and just be able to pick them. So I think we're good. We did 24. So, and I'm going to go ahead and deselect what I have. So, okay, it's looking good. A couple elements are missing. We're missing the New York Times subtitle. We're also missing the yellow star over the image. So let's start with that yellow star. So for this one, I'm going to do that same thing. I'm going to embed, so I can just type in embed or new stack or even wrap. There's a lot of, I've tried to make it so a lot of different words will work for the actions, but basically we want to put this thing in a Z stack. So I'm going to go Z stack, and we want to do a new stack with this item. And now I've got that pie image inside a Z stack. I'm going to add an SF symbol. So add element after SF symbol, perfect. Just typed, all I typed in was SF. And this is going to be just like the media library feature of images, where all the symbols are, you know, pulled up, and you can go through the categories or you can just filter and search. So we want a star. So I'll just type in star, and you'll see, here we go. Star, restart, star.fill. That's what we want. Okay. So far so good. We've got those two layered. We need to move it down the alignment, right? We want the star to be in the corner. So for that, I'm going to go up to the layered stack. And I'm just going to start typing in. So I think what I would recommend is, I would recommend going through the actions the first several times you do this, just because it's really safe and really fast and fun to just kind of see all your choices. You know, I feel like it's just so easy to discover them. And then so in this case, I already know I want it to be bottom trailing. So from that first Command K menu, I could just type in bottom, and you can see bottom trailing. And boom, the star is down there. So now I can go down to the star, and I'm going to give it the color yellow. So again, so many levels to this. I could do add modifier, and I could do color. Or where is that? There we go, color. I think I found an interesting bug that should be a little bit higher up, so that will be fixed. But color, and I could go down to yellow, right? Or I could just type in yellow. So personally, I've just been typing in the color, and I can go add color, yellow. Awesome. Now, a couple things we need to do. We need to kind of add some padding and bring that up. So I'm just going to go padding, add. Padding asks you what sides you want to use, and we want to use all. And that's like pretty small. So maybe let's give the SF symbol a large font. So I'm just going to go all the way up to large title. I like how that looks. It's pretty big, but I think it looks kind of friendly. It looks kind of interesting. So that looks good. So let's just finish up this design. So I'll just give you a couple more little you know, real usage moments here. So I'm going to go up to Blackberry Apple Pie, and I want to add, let's do a font, maybe title one. Okay, that feels good. And let's go to serif. So that's the New York font family. That looks good. Let's duplicate this font, and let's change this to say the New York Times. Now for this, I want to bring it down in font size. That's too much. Let's just do headline. And I don't want it to be serif, so I'm going to type in sans to get to the sans serif font, which is SF Pro. That looks pretty good. I also want it to be the secondary color. So add color secondary. And everything's looking fine. The only thing that doesn't really look fine, I think the spacing looks a little off. So I'm going to normalize that by selecting the vertical stack. And I'm just going to go to set spacing, and let's just do 4. Okay. So that feels pretty good. And that was all done from the keyboard, which you couldn't do before. So I'm really excited about this feature. I feel really proud of it. And I've already gotten just some, you know, people have been excited about it. So it is really, it's fun for me making these updates. Now, when you give it a try, please let me know if you find anything that you feel is missing or that you tried to do that wasn't there, because I'm super happy to update these actions. So all that's left in this video, I'm going to show you three actions that I think you should know. So here's the first one. The first action I think you should know is the move element action, because in this situation, I knew what the design was I wanted to make, so it was pretty easy. But let's say we're experimenting and we want this image to actually be not here, but down here. How do we do that? Well, you can select the element you want to move, Command K, and then if you start typing in move, there's a move element action. So this works a couple of ways. It lets you just move things one spot up or one spot down, but the amazing thing is it lets you actually move things to other named locations in your design. This is something that we can do because SwiftUI is this beautiful set of stacks, and a lot of times designers actually name their elements. So what we want to do here, I'm going to go ahead and hit Command K, and I'm going to go down to move, and I'm going to say move it after the New York Times. Boom. Just like that, it is down at the bottom. So that is really essential. We can move it back up by going Command K, move element before BlackBerry Pie. BlackBerry Apple Pie. Now, what I would do when I'm doing this move is I actually just type in the name of the element I'm trying to move it after. So I know I want this to be after the New York Times. So I'm going to hit Command K. I'm going to just start typing in New York Times, and you'll see that brings up the move action. So move element after the New York Times. Pretty cool. Okay, the second action that I really want you to know about is the rename element action. This is one I think you should know because it helps a lot of these other actions work well. So basically what you can do, like for example, right now we have this part. This I think could have a much better name than layered stack. We could probably go, you know, rename element. And I think I would change that to maybe just image, or let's say like recipe image. So you'll see now it changes it over here, but it also gives us the opportunity to move things by that name. So I can go move element, and now it'll actually say after recipe image. There we go, after recipe image. You can move it after the actual image inside, that's what that is. Or you can move it into that recipe image layered stack, which I don't think we want. But for example, let me just show you how that would look. If we move it after the here, you know? That doesn't really look right. So I'm gonna go ahead and move that out to after New York Times. Awesome, we're back where we were. And let's move this back up. Move element to before BlackBerry Apple Pie. Oh, that actually was not where we were. That was the, this should have been before New York Times. There we go. And now this can go up to before BlackBerry Apple Pie. Awesome. So, you know, really quick, and you can see having the names really helps a lot. Finally, the last action that I want you to know, this is one that is, I think, the kind of the most impressive shortcut. There is an action to set a frame, both width and height, in one step. It's such a common thing that we do when we're designing. So I wanted to do something really specific. So how does this one work? Let me show you. So first, I'm just going to remove this frame that I put at the top to kind of really make the problem apparent. Okay, so right now we've got this thing, and it's too big. We want to make this image smaller. That's really the issue here. So what I can do is I can go down to the image, hit Command K. And when you go to add a frame, you'll see a couple things. First, you'll see this default size. You see the options to set, you know, full width, full height, etc. But what you can do is you can just start typing in something X something. So I'm going to do like 250 X 200. And that intelligently gets read into a width and a height. And just like that, it gets set into that size. So I think here I need to, here it doesn't really make that much sense because the image has its natural aspect ratio. So I'm gonna go ahead and reset that height because we really don't mind how tall it is in this situation, let's say. And actually let's edit that width to be bigger again. Let's go set width and let's go up to, let's go higher. Let's go 450 this time. Awesome. So that thing where I was just typing in the width, that works, you know, with single numbers too. So if you just start typing in 150, that is a width. But if you start typing in 150 x2, you know, 24, then that is a precise width and height dimension. So pretty cool. I'm definitely going to be adding in other shortcut actions like that. And it would help me a lot if after you gave this a try, you would just leave a comment or DM me on Twitter with an action that you were looking for, maybe that wasn't there, or feel free to send me a design that you've made because I'd love to see it. And this update is available now. It's on Mac and iPad. So it works with any keyboard, doesn't need to be a magic keyboard. And yeah, I hope you enjoy it. Thank you for watching and I'll talk to you soon.